beaucoup aussi sur Renaissance Band. Il y a une très grande diversité de musiciens de différents pays. Qu'est-ce que ça apporte au niveau musical?
A world about the band Renaissance Band, the diversity of the musicians. What does it bring to your music?
What does it bring to my music?
Yeah, to have so many kinds of people coming.
I think
everywhere.
Just international vibe, you know, just a world vibe. It's different nationalities, but it's one. You know, my band is really together. We've been playing for a while now, so my band consists of Suriname people, Saint Martin, Aruba. And Côte d'Ivoire, yeah, every coast, you know what I'm saying? So it's people from everywhere, but it's a great vibe, man. It's a great vibe, and it just makes it very relaxed. We have I think that's one of the best things about my show, you know. I have a crew that is very connected.
Yeah, we can feel it.
Tu fais partie de la nouvelle génération reggae. Est-ce que tu peux nous parler des fondations qui t'ont inspiré, et éventuellement un petit mot sur Gregory Isaac qui t'a expliqué il y a pas longtemps?
Yes, so you're representing the new generation in reggae, so can you tell us what's your inspiration come from? And maybe a word about Gregory Isaacs.
About Gregory Isaacs, you know, Gregory is a reggae legend, you know. I think everybody knows. I know Gregory from my youth. I hear him Gregory tunes from my little boy. So Gregory was a big man, you know. Extra amount of respect to Gregory. Gregory is just legendary, you know, just like Dennis, just like Bob, you know. You have Gregory too. I just see it like that.
Okay, and about your inspiration, what's
my inspiration? Well,
foundation, what you?
I think everything, you know. I don't listen to only reggae music, you know. I listen to some reggae music, but I also listen to some soul music, and I also listen to some hip hop music, and I think I also listen to some pop music, because you know, just because of it's all around, so. My musical influence is very broad, man. I'm influenced by, I listen to a lot of old music, you know. I listen to some, I like old soul, like Al Green, and you know, that kind of crazy shit. So it's very broad. I think you're gonna really hear it on my new album. I think my new album is more than ever really my thing, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, thank you.
Une question sur le reggae en Hollande.
Question about the reggae scene in Holland. We don't hear about it. Are you alone?
Well, no, I am not alone. But Holland does not have a big reggae scene. You know, you have a scene. It's kind of different. You know, Holland does not have a big like sound system scene like how you would have in Germany or France with all the sound system. You know. There are a few sounds that do good. You have jam rock sound, mm-hmm. Amsterdam, you know, with DJ Waxfin, and that's more or less the biggest sound in Holland, you know, in Amsterdam. They really run it. You have Herbalife, that's a real international sound. But besides that, you don't really have much more. But you do have a lot of talented artists, you know. You have Michael X, Cali Boy, you have Lyrical, you have Smiley. I think Holland has a real culture of a lot of Caribbean people, you know. You have people from Suriname and people from the Antilles. So you have actually quite a few people in Holland who are pretty good reggae music.
Is it because it's so small that you turn in other countries for production, like Germany, or?
With my last album, yeah, you know what I'm saying, because I did, there weren't any reggae producers in Holland, you know. I could, the best reggae production in Holland is if I did it myself, so you know what I'm saying, so that makes sense then. But with my new CD now, I produce most of it myself, you know what I'm saying, with different people, with somebody. I produce it with different members of my band. I did some productions with my guitarist, some productions with my bass man. So most of the new album is like I said, it's really me, you know what I'm saying? It's me doing my thing, my production, my style, man. It's very different. I really can't wait for it to come out, you know.
Me too.
Donc dans les projets, il y a l'album qui sort en avril. Et quels sont les projets de Ziggi? Quels sont les projets de Ziggi et Renaissance Band?
So in your projects there is the release of this album.
Yeah.
And what are your own projects and the projects with the Renaissance Band?
Yeah, projects. I don't know. The main thing right now is of course my album. You know, my album is coming in April. That's the main thing. So besides that, we're not doing too much right now. We're doing some shows still, obviously. I'm in France now. We're going to Senegal next week. I'm going to be in Senegal for a big festival. That's supposed to be, really nice. And I think that's my last show for the year. You know, I'm really getting ready to come with my new thing. So we are in preparation for that. I'm going to start rehearsal. You know, we have a new album, so we have a new repertoire to put together. You know, it's a whole new thing, I can't wait.
Okay.
Et pour finir, quel message tu veux donner aux auditeurs sur ta musique et sur ta façon de... sur tes messages en général dans ta musique. Le message pour les auditeurs.
Yes, to finish, what message would you give to our audience?
Well, I think just a message of be a good vibes, man, you know, just be a positiveness. I mean, I'm still a reggae artist, so you know what I'm saying, most of my tunes is positive tunes, it's mostly a conscious message, and that, you know, that's what I'm saying to these French people. I only speak what I really feel, so it's just feel real vibes. And like I said, I have X amount of love for France. I played more in France than in Holland, you know, so it's crazy. I played more in France than anywhere else. So this was really like my second home, and we were in France a lot. So X amount of love to my French people. You guys are wicked.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Juste un petit mot quand même sur ton saxophoniste. Qui en France communique beaucoup avec le public. Voilà, en France c'est un peu particulier pour lui. Le rapport avec le public français du saxophone.
Do you have a word about the relation between your French saxophonist who can connect you with the public?
Eddie is the oldest member of the band, so he's like a papa, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, when we out, you know, Eddie wants to sleep and Eddie wants to, you know. And in France, he always takes leave because nobody can speak French, you know. So every time we come to France, he becomes the manager, you know, he talks to everybody and does everything else. That's Eddie, man.
Okay. Maybe I have one more question. Is there a frustration for you with the people who may not understand what you say?
But I think maybe a little bit, you know, because you hope that people can really understand, so they really feel you 100%, you know what I'm saying? Not just hear a melody and like, hey, it's cool, but really, really hear what you're saying, you know what I'm saying? So that would be nice. So, you know, I mean, I understand this is France, so people don't speak English generally, but usually I get a okay enough reaction that I get a feeling that enough people understand what I'm saying to make it, you know,
okay,
a good enough vibe.
Okay.
It was cool.
Okay, thank you.
Une dernière chose, c'est possible d'avoir un jingle pour les émissions, en fait.
Ah, yes.
Last question. Last question. Non, je crois qu'il faudrait qu'on parle un peu de ce que j'ai mis.
Pour la même chose.
Ouais, et puis de ce que j'aimerais faire. C'est une surprise. Okay.
Can you say a word about the featuring that will be released in your album, or
the featuring,
or just you?
Okay. Come on, sure. About my feature, well, on my album this time, I have quite a few featurings. I have some Dutch artists, because, like I said, this album is very different. So I have a Dutch, I have two Dutch hip hop artists. I have Pete Philly. Mm-hmm. He's a very popular hip hop artist in Holland, and Mr. Probs. Mm-hmm. On two tracks. I have Lyrical. He's like up and coming dancehall, okay, reggae artist. Like I said, this one is real me, you know what I'm saying? I have Michael X.
Okay, so you promote young artists or?
Well, not too many, just that one, you know. But I have Michael X as the mm-hmm. artist that's on the same label as me on Rocking Vibes, you know what I'm saying? And he's a very, very good singer too. So I only put artists on it that I know that are really good, you know, that I really feel. I have Etana on it from Jamaica. Okay. Mm-hmm. And I have one big combination. I have one combination with Omar Perry, okay, Tipper Irie, and Perfect.
On the same combination?
On the same track. Okay. Yeah. So it's really something, man.
Very
just
impatient to okay, so to finish, maybe we could have one jingle for
What's the name?
Emission Redeem.
Okay, Emission Redeem.
Every Monday, 8 to 10 p.m. on Radio Campus.
Okay, every Monday, 10 Emission. Brilliant. Okay, cool, man, let's do it. This is just audio, right? No video for you. Emission rhythm. Okay, you ready? Yo, she takes me so far away. Mary really makes my day. Me and her connect in a passionate way. Hey, yo, this is Ziggy Recado coming straight out of Amsterdam, where the ganja is legal right now. You're tuned into Emission Rhythm, the number one radio show in France on Radio Campus 102.4 FM on your dial. This is the number one dancehall reggae radio show you're gonna hear, so keep it right here. You hear what I'm saying? Salute!
Thank you very much. Could we have one more for the show?
Okay, what's the answer?
One
group. Also Emission. Radio Sud. Yes. Sud Bass and Song.
Yes.
Bass and Song. Okay. Alright, you ready? Yo. Check it out, Nobas. Girl, I really need to tell you this. France massive people, them is just the wickedest. You better know. Girl, I really need to tell you this. One drop sound is just on top of the, yo, this is Ziggy Recado from Amsterdam, where the ganja is legal. And right about now, we're listening to One Drop, the number one radio show in the world, on 101.8 FM on your dial. Radio Suit Bass and Song. Keep it right here, you heard, because this is the spot to be. Salute.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
We could really
last
thing. Okay, photo.
Yeah.
Oh, I next. Okay, reggae.
Reggae
S. That ever. Okay. What else is an ancient? Alright, you ready? Well, I'm on the rise. I got to get mine this year. Have to make a million, I swear. Hey, yo, this is Ziggy Recado, and right about now, you're locked up to reggae.fr, number one reggae website in the world. Keep it right here. You hear me? Salute.
Rup.
Boo. Boom again.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Very cool. Do you have news from the lab?
Give me.
Because I saw.
No!
Yo, these man's are fucking up the vibe big time now, boss.
We were supposed to hear today, but we didn't hear anything, so I still do not know. I will hear tomorrow. I am like,
sorry, really sorry for you.
It is really fucked up. So the lab, you know, it costs a lot of money, but I hope, I am praying, please, let me get back my album, you know.
Yes, because it is the album coming.
Yeah, yeah,
Rap. Ziggi Recado and the Renaissance Band in France, where it's snowing big time. Boop.